He's starred opposite Hollywood A-listers, including Helen Hunt and Cuba Gooding Jr. And now, Blake Cooper Griffin joins us in the studio.
You're tuned in to AfterBuzz TV, the ESPN of TV talk. Now, let the buzz begin.
Hi, AfterBuzzers, and welcome to Mini Spotlight, where we highlight rising stars in music, TV, and film. I'm your host, Amy Cassandra Martinez, and we are joined by Blake Cooper Griffin, someone else that also goes by three names.
Three How names. Fantastic. Three names, yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. I'm BCG. Do your friends call you by an acronym?
You know, hey, Aim. They don't.
Oh,
they don't,
hey, Aim.
Aim. Amy.
No, so it's Amy.
Cassandra Martinez.
There's so no ACM.
Yeah, but no one does that.
You should, maybe you
I
should
mean, you
start
can
it.
Start calling me that.
I'll call you ACM. You call me BCG. Okay, what's the new thing?
See, I love it because yours sounds like a really cool like fashion
brand.
Label.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mine
yeah.
sounds like a news outlet.
Just as rich. Yeah.
Yeah. BCG.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I love it.
BCG.
So let's just get started talking about BEERFEST.
Yes.
Tell us all about it.
Well, right? I'm super excited. We are BEERFEST, Thirst for Victory, is a new movie that is out. It just came out on the CW seed. And it's sort of a revamp or a reboot of the college cult classic of BEERFEST that was brilliantly done by Broken Lizard. And so we're sort of picking up and it's kind of inspired by that. And it's got a great cast. It's about a group of 20 somethings that are sort of realizing that post-college life is not as exciting as we thought it was going to be.
It's hard.
It is. Yes. You have to pay bills. And
what
like,
is that?
Yes, and like cook dinner.
Oh, grocery shop.
You know, and do laundry. It's sort of, it's sort of these people sort of navigating through just getting out of college and starting jobs that they don't necessarily like, that they don't necessarily want to end up in. My character, Scott, is sort of the ringleader of the group, and he decides that he's going to rejoin beer tournaments, just like he did in college, with his group of friends, and he's going to sort of reconnect to his college days. So it's a really fun movie. It's really a blast, and I love that it's available for everybody on CW Seed. It's their first original movie that they've put out there. So we're really excited about it.
That's such an honor
too. Well, yes, we should have gotten a trophy,
exactly.
First original, yeah.
In the shape of a beer.
In this, yeah. That,
I mean,
should have been a producer, an executive, right here.
Right. Well, there's always my other life, right?
All right.
So, well, speaking about lives, what was your college life like?
Well, I had an interesting college experience.
Yes.
I went to a conservatory.
Yeah.
I went to the North Carolina School of the Arts, School of Drama, and it's a very rigorous school. You sort of go to school Monday through Saturday. It's 10 a.m. I mean, well, really, academics sort of start at 8. You go 8 to 10 academics, and then you do 11 to 11 arts classes every day. And then you rehearse on Saturday as well. So it was a very different type of experience. People that got to go to college football games and all that kind of stuff, that wasn't us. It was a small school, but it's an amazing school and an amazing place. I've met so many great friends of mine that I'm still really close with, and I'm really proud to be from there. We ended up graduating a class of about, I think, 20 or 22 actors.
Oh,
and then
wow.
That's sort of what got me my, I was really privileged being from the South. I'm from South Carolina originally, to have a place that would kind of help me to navigate what it would be to pursue this dream of acting. I'm very grateful, and I'm very glad that I did it. So yeah.
Well, I'm thinking back of the first time you realized, yes, I want to go into acting. What was that like for you?
What was that like for me? Oh, that's a good question. It was something that I think that I always sort of had an interest in. I think mainly it's sort of, for me, was about being a curious person. I mean, I don't know that it was originally a thought of, like, I'm going to be an actor. It was that I was interested in everything. And then when I watched people on TV and saw that they got to experience different circumstances and be a part of you know, be a part of different worlds and try out new things and learn about history and learn about, you know, beer drinking. that might be something that I would want to be involved in. And so, yeah, I from a very early age, I got involved in theater and started doing that kind of stuff. So, yeah, it was great.
When it feels like you were able to live that stereotypical college life by doing BEERFEST.
Yeah, you know? That's true. You're right about that. I've actually played a couple of frat boy characters, and then this was sort of like he's just out of college, but it sort of was revisiting his college days. So yeah, I'm making up for lost time. How I like to think about it.
I like that. What kind of research did you have to do?
I've been practicing all my life. No, I actually have been. I am pretty good at beer games.
Oh, really?
Pretty darn good. Pretty good at Flip Cup. And this is not Flip Cup. Well, I was thinking this is
beer
the
pong.
Beer pong, and I'm good at Flip Cup, too.
Flip Cup is the one where you flip the cup.
So Flip Cup, for people that are over 21, I'm not advocating for anyone that's not, but for people that are over 21, Flip Cup is where you put some sort of liquid, usually beer, in a cup, and you drink it.
Red
and then you
Solo
have to,
Cup.
Red no, Solo Cup.
That's like...
Could be Blue Solo Cup, though,
oh,
too.
Oh, Blue too. Oh, whoa.
Yeah.
It's revolutionary.
It's 2018. We can do whatever we want. So you can, you know, you put it in there, and then you drink it in a line, and you have to flip it and have to land it.
Yes.
And then you would go. So anyway, that's what's up. That's Flip Cup.
I like that you're telling us this, because there's some of us, I mean, I didn't go to a conservatory, but I went to a pretty, it was a faith-based university.
Okay, yeah.
And I was too busy just, like, fangirling over all the classes that I could take.
Oh,
like
wow.
Theater.
Cool. So did you take a bunch of theater classes?
I did.
Yeah.
I did.
Awesome.
I didn't get to be, you know, like, a college frat guy, but I got to play a dude.
You did?
I did.
What did you play?
A dude. Like, we had to... like, mimic someone that we knew, and I picked the complete opposite
okay.
of me, this
okay.
tall dude.
All right.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
So, but, I mean, like, thank you for telling us the rules of Flip Cup. I think this
sure.
is essential to any college experience when you're being responsible.
Yes, over 21.
I like that you started with that. So now that you've been in BEERFEST and, you know, multiple things, like Preacher, where do you see yourself in 10 years? Like, if you could send a little message to yourself for 10 years from now.
Blake, what are you doing? No,
Blake
in 10 years, where are you? In 10 years, I hope that I am playing parts that are interesting and different. I mean, I think that one thing that I like about this career, you know, what draws me to it is the transformational element of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I like playing things that are outside of myself, you know. I got to do, you know, you said I did Preacher, and I played a guy that was sort of a part of a world that, you know, I had never been a part of. And then in BEERFEST, you know, I didn't go to a traditional college where you would have that sort of, you know, that sort of social life. And I've played other parts where I played, like, the bad guy. I played the villain a couple times. And then I've played, you know, major crimes, and I was playing like a crazy guy from the OC, really funny. I mean, what I really like about this career is that I get to transform and play different things. So I hope that in 10 years, Blake, you're still doing that and hopefully getting paid a lot for it.
Oh, yeah. You'll just like,
yeah.
Big mansion.
Yeah, yeah. I like this. Is this how you say...
I mean, I don't know if people are still doing this, but I just do it. It's like, yeah.
Okay, that means lots of money.
It's like money.
Okay,
it's like bills.
Yeah.
Hopefully
yeah.
$100 bill.
Hopefully,
but yeah.
yeah.
I mean,
I like that.
What? No one's done that recently? Oh, no. I'm probably super out.
No, I
it's
think it's
fun.
Great. No, now you taught me something. You taught me something today.
This is how this works.
Yep.
Yes.
It's reciprocal.
That's a big
teaching.
Word, but I know what
yes.
that means.
Okay.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
If you could just tell everyone where they can find you on social media so they can just, you know, follow
yes.
you.
Yes. You can follow me on Instagram at Blake Cooper Griffin. My full name right there. On Twitter, you can follow me at The Grifster, THEGRIFFSTER.
Mm-hmm.
That was really good. And on Facebook, you can just search Blake Cooper Griffin Actor, and then we'll be in touch. You'll be able to find out all the stuff that's going on with me.
That's so exciting. And you guys can find me on all social media at Amy Cassandra, MTZ, which is an abbreviation for Martinez. I couldn't put my whole name. Like
there you go.
It's just very long.
It's great.
But yes. Thank you again for joining
thank
us.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
And thank you guys for watching Mini Spotlight. We'll see you guys later.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.